All right, welcome to part 5 of my CNC router build. So this build is pretty much done, and this video is just going to be an overview of what I accomplished from now to part 4. So this will consist of the clamping system, a first test run, and our dust shoe. I hope you guys enjoy, because I'm super excited to show you guys. All right, so here's the router. And so I 3D printed out this dust shoe. I designed this myself. It came out pretty good, but I can't complain too much. So right here, this is where the vacuum nozzle would go, and then it just sucks it in right here, and I put the duct tape down because I don't have brushes just yet, but this will go down and compress, and it just returns to its normal form after you release the compression off of it, or you can just bend it back like I just did. But yeah, this just slides on, and the nice thing with it is that I can adjust the height for different types of bits. So yeah, pretty simple, nothing too complicated. All right, so here is my overview of the clamping system on my CNC router. So I had a 2x4 cut in half with a hole drilled every single inch. And then what I did was I drilled out the hole so I can put this bolt pretty much anywhere with this 90 degree steel bracket. And then I just tapped a hole in the steel bracket, and this gives us our clamp function. But then at the end here, I have this spring clamp to serve as like a stationary block. So when I screw this bolt in, it just clamps in the wood on our table. And then to make sure I have this mounted perfectly, like at a 90 degree angle with our table, I put in this piece of cut plywood right here, and this serves greatly. This gives us a pretty much a perfect 90 degree angle, and I'm very happy with the result of this clamping system. It seems like it works very well. Alright, so that was my first legitimate test of my CNC. So overall, this came out pretty good. The letters are very clear and very readable. And our clamping system worked awesome. So there was no wobble, no nothing in this. So the clamping system is very secure and it works. But one other thing that works even better is the dust collection system. So there is no dust at all, and the vacuum sucked everything up. I'll show you how I have the vacuum hose connected in a minute, but clamping system was awesome. The vacuum system was awesome. The only thing that I didn't like is that this is my fault. There was just a mismeasurement, and we ended up going into our clamp a little bit, but that is my fault, and it's not a big deal at all. But other than that, this thing is absolutely awesome, and it came out extremely nice. Alright, before I end the video, I will have a breakdown of the cost in the description. Alright, thank you so much for watching, and this concludes my CNC router build for now. I may add a few things in the future, but for now, it is done. Now, if you're not, make sure you're subscribed, and if you want to leave a like, that would be a huge help. And if you have any questions about my CNC router build, please leave them in the comments, because this was hands down the biggest build I've ever done so far. And I wouldn't be surprised if people are confused, because there's a lot to go through. And if you need any clarification, please leave a question. I'll be happy to answer it. But that pretty much sums it up. As always, thank you for watching. Goodbye.